Hello, this is the start of the Explain series, where I'll be providing various assets for my current projects and explain how they work. There's a link to this project posted in my GitHub with the assets described in this video. Our goal for today is to create a conveyor belt with moving arrows that pushes objects in sync with the animation. The first step is to make a box that can move objects. All that must be done here is whenever an object is sitting on the conveyor belt, we simply move it forward. It's that easy, with no bugs or unintended consequences. After fixing all the bugs I created, the next step is to create a scrolling shader. This shader moves the texture along the object at a fixed rate over time using the shader graph. This allows for a configurable animation speed that we can align with the movement of our objects. One of the only problems that comes from this is that it doesn't look like a conveyor belt. Yet. We can hop into Blender and make a quick conveyor belt by cutting a cylinder in half and stretching it out. Now we need to animate our texture. One possible method is called tri-planar mapping, where we project an image onto one or more sides of an object. We can then animate it to give it the simulation of moving the conveyor belt. The built-in tri-planar mapping does not normally work in this instance, so I had to make my own. The animation works best when we only project onto the top of the conveyor belt, and we essentially repeat the same image multiple times and animate it to move forward. There's some deformation and misalignment along the edge of the conveyor belt. Although the animation works for curved or deformed surfaces, but I have one last idea to make it look even better. This last option involves defining a UV mapping for the object so that we can describe how the texture is drawn on it. It's like unwrapping the faces of a die to make a T shape where each square on our paper represents a different face of the die. That way, when we draw on the paper, our program will know where to map that face on the die. For our conveyor belt, we wrap one piece of paper around the curved part with a seam at the bottom. Now to animate the belt, we simply must slide the paper with the arrows drawn on it around the edges of the belt. This provides the smoothest and cleanest effect of all the considered options and is what I'm using in my game right now. I hope you found this informative. All these assets are free to use and posted on my GitHub at the link in the description. I'll have another weekly update this week showing off the conveyor belts. Thanks for watching.